Hey guys, it's Splash. Wanted to record a little bit of a quick introduction here. So this is cut from my 1 hour live stream. I did four parts. So there is an all-pro prediction, a season prediction, an awards prediction, and five rookies I think could make the all-pro team. So go ahead, check out the other parts. This is just one of the four parts. So have a nice day and drop a like on the video.
Let's start with the Thursday night game. I will take the Buffalo Bills tonight. I think they win by seven. They'll break their streak of double-digit wins or multi-possession wins. I believe their last 18 victories have all been decided by at least 10 points. I do think that streak ends tonight. And I'll say, I'm going to say 27 Bills getting the W. All right, so let's go through the AFC. I will take Indianapolis over Houston this week, Cincinnati over Pittsburgh, Baltimore with the Jets, Miami at home, Chargers at home, Washington at home, Carolina at home, Chiefs on the road, Titans at home, Broncos Monday Night Football, 49ers, Eagles. I'm going to take Atlanta, give me Minnesota to start, and I will take the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. All right, so hot start for everyone. I'll flip it to conference mode. If you have any questions, feel free to drop it in the comments. I'm more than happy to answer in between each segment. Week two, I will take the Chargers on the road, Steelers at home, Jags at home. I will take the Browns, begrudgingly. Ravens at home, Broncos at home, Bills at home, Raiders at home, Cowboys at home, New Orleans at home, Carolina on the road, Detroit, Rams, Niners, Packers, and I'll take the Eagles. I know that's a lot of home teams, but that's the vibe I'm getting this week, or week two at least. Week three, give me Pittsburgh on the road, Tennessee, Baltimore, Cincinnati, Kansas City, Buffalo, Chargers, Da Bears, Denver, Minnesota, Philly, Carolina, Seattle, Rams, Bucks, Cowboys. All right, week four. So a couple, six undefeated teams left. Bills, Chargers, Ravens, Broncos, then Eagles and Panthers. I'll take the Bengals, Thursday Night Football, Chargers, Colts, Bills, Steelers, Raiders. I'll take Cleveland, Philly, Green Bay, Tampa Bay, New Orleans, Dallas, Detroit, New York Giants, Carolina, San Francisco. So four undefeated teams remain. Here we go. Week five. Take Denver, Miami, Buffalo, Jacksonville, Chargers, Ravens, Chiefs, Patriots, Titans, Packers, Vikings, Saints, Bucks, 49ers, Rams, Cardinals. All right, week six, Colts, Patriots, Chiefs, Chargers, Packers, Saints, Ravens, Buccaneers, Miami, Washington, San Francisco, Seattle, LA, Philly. All right, the Chargers are the last remaining undefeated team. Tennessee, Baltimore, Vegas, Denver, Miami, Cincinnati, Jacksonville, Chargers, 49ers, Patriots, Cardinals, Cowboys, Packers, and Bucks. Week eight, Denver, New England, Tennessee, Cincinnati, Tampa, New Orleans, Philadelphia, Miami, Indianapolis, Buffalo, Dallas, Minnesota, Atlanta, Seattle, Rams, New England, Buffalo, Vegas, Kansas City, Philly, Miami, Cincinnati, Chargers, Saints. So the Chargers stay undefeated. Packers, Commanders, Cardinals, Buccaneer. We'll go Rams. Rams. Titans, Chiefs, Dolphins, Vegas. We'll go New York, Pittsburgh, Buffalo, San Francisco to knock the Chargers to the land of the teams with the loss. Carolina, Chicago, Tampa Bay, LA Rams, Packers, Eagles. Okay, that does feel weird with all the home teams, but I mean, maybe Dallas beats Green Bay. Other than that, I do think the better team is on the road. Denver, perhaps. Week 11, New England, Buffalo, Denver, Kansas City, Cincinnati, Green Bay, Houston, Indianapolis, Baltimore, Saints, Lions, Falcons, Minnesota, Arizona. All right, week 12, I will take Cincinnati, Miami, Baltimore, Pittsburgh, Buffalo, Minnesota, Jets, Denver, Tampa Bay, Vegas, Arizona, Kansas City, Dallas, Washington, San Francisco, and Green Bay. Week 13, Bills, Browns. This is with Deshaun Watson, Baltimore, Vegas, Cincinnati, Minnesota, Detroit, Pittsburgh, Philadelphia, San Francisco, Dallas, Green Bay, New York Giants, Rams, Saints, Tennessee, Buffalo, Cincinnati, Pittsburgh, Miami, Kansas City, LA Rams, Cowboys, Patriots. I'll go Arizona. Arizona at home is tough. Detroit, New York Giants, San Francisco, and Seattle. Week 15, Cleveland, Buffalo, Kansas City, LA Chargers, Vegas, Minnesota, Pittsburgh, Dallas, New York Jets, Denver, Tampa Bay, Seattle, New Orleans, Washington, Philadelphia, Green Bay. Get into the home stretch here, week 16. Give me Jets, Titans, Bengals, Steelers, Colts, Bills, Chiefs, Ravens, Browns, Green Bay, LA, Minnesota, Carolina, San Francisco, Dallas, Tampa Bay. Week 17, take Denver, Houston, Baltimore, Miami, Cincinnati, Tennessee, I'll get back to that one. Indianapolis, Vegas, Seattle. I'll go to the Jets. I'll go to the Jets on the road. Rams, Bucks, Cardinals, Lions, Eagles, Packers. And that Cleveland-Washington game, both teams are 5-10. Both teams are way out of playoff position. I'll take Cleveland. Week 18, Kansas City, Denver, Pittsburgh. Jacksonville, Cincinnati, Buffalo, Indianapolis, Miami, San Francisco, LA Rams, Packers, Bears, Saints, Eagles, Cowboys, and Bucks. So there are my season predictions there. The AFC, the Bills are the one, Bengals 2, Chiefs 3, Titans 4, Ravens 5, Dolphins 6, Broncos 7, Steelers, Chargers, Raiders all above 500. In the NFC, Packers 1, Bucks 2, Rams 3, Eagles 4, 49ers 5, Cowboys 6, Saints 7. So the teams I have missing the playoffs that made it last season, Pittsburgh, Vegas, New England, and the AFC. In the NFC, I have Arizona. I think it might just be Arizona. Yeah, it's just Arizona. So those are the four teams I have, you know, swapping out new teams, Baltimore, Miami, Denver, as well as New Orleans. I could be swayed either way with New Orleans or Minnesota, just in general. I think the worst team in the league will be Houston. Don't anticipate them winning many games. next to them, I think Atlanta will be bad. Chicago will be bad. I think the Jags and Jets will have a better, you'll have a better perception of them than 4-13, but I don't see too many wins on their schedule. I think the same can be said for the Giants and the Commanders. Seattle, I think they can just kind of claw their way to 5 wins. Detroit, 6 wins. Carolina might be better than 6 wins, maybe get to 7. Could be a sneaky playoff team. New England, I don't anticipate being great. Cleveland gets behind the eight ball really early because of the Deshaun Watson suspension. Indianapolis has a tough schedule with tough games, but even then they finish one game behind Tennessee. Cardinals, it's a tough season. 49ers twice, Rams twice, but let's go into the playoffs. I have Baltimore beating the Titans, the Chiefs beating the Dolphins, the Bengals winning at home, the Niners beating the Eagles, the Rams beating the Cowboys, and the Buccaneers beating the Saints. The second round, I have the Bills and Bengals advancing to the AFC Championship game alongside the Rams and Packers. I have the Bills and Packers going to the Super Bowl, the Green Bay Packers getting the victory. So there's my predictions with Aaron Rodgers winning Super Bowl MVP. You can take a screenshot of that and roast me in 3 months when the Broncos start 0-8 or something stupid like that. So there we have it. 14 minutes, every regular season game predicted, what I think will happen, could happen, what might happen, plus the 13 playoff games, so in total 285 game predictions. And there we are.
Thank you guys for watching the video. Hope you had a wonderful time. Drop a like, drop a sub, and have a wonderful football season. And remember, chop on, go Braves.